My mom was the person I really got my sense of humor directly from. She was a very edgy lady. My sister and I'd be going off to go swimming at the pond near our house, and she'd open the kitchen window and in this kind of fake June Cleaver voice go, "Don't drown, kids!" And we'd go, "We won't, Mom!" You know, we thought that was just a hilarious thing to joke about. That was my mom. Whatever you write on any topic, if you write a humor column, somebody will be offended. Sometimes really offended. Even at something you can't imagine somebody would be offended by, somebody will be. And you just can't do anything about it. Most of your readers are decent people, smart people. Some of them are just jerks. You know, they're not really your readers, they're just internet jerks, the anonymous commenter jerks who just get off on being cruel and vicious. Every day, you know, I would think, I'm not funny anymore, I've used up all my ideas, I can't. That's sort of a normal part of the writing process. And I think if you don't have that, you won't write as well, because you'll settle for whatever you wrote. If you're not really critical of yourself, you won't do your best writing. You're basically thinking joke, joke, joke. At least I am, because I don't usually have a point to make. I'm trying to amuse the reader for 800 words. So I'll start on one topic and end on a completely different topic, as long as I can keep it going, make it funny. I don't think you could possibly do what I did back in the 80s now. The whole idea of a 800 word humor essay is almost quaint now. Now, a news event happens, immediately 8 million people write tweets about it. So by the next day, every possible joke has already been used. And so nobody's gonna have a newspaper column come out a couple of days later that's gonna add anything to the humor that's already been mined from that event. There's a cycle, and people discover your humor and they think it's brilliant, and then they read it for a while and they get used to it and whatever, and then at some point they decide you're not any good anymore, and they tell you that, you know, it used to be much better. But at the same time, somebody else is just now discovering, and they think you're the great. So I just learned to accept that.